K98 Talk is expanding its lineup for 2015. This means we are expanding our advertising base. Whether you're a startup trying to push through to the next level, or an established business trying to supplement your advertising budget, web-based advertising is a solid investment. Thanks to Talk's newest partnership with TuneIn Radio and instant access to our sister station, K98 FM, we give you worldwide access at a reasonable cost. Interested parties should email us at sales@k98fm.com.
In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't gonna be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
Game on, where progressives fear us and rhinos tremble. Welcome to the political jungle. I'm JD.
This is Stacey. No one is safe. No one is spared.
Lock up the children.
And the old folk.
Welcome to the world of libertarian conservatarian.
A lot of talk about a third party there, Edith. Geez, I hope that party's not over at Jefferson's house. I don't know if those people drink the same kind of beers we do. Good Thursday evening, May 19th, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. JD and Stacey here. Game on, part of that Conservative Commandos radio network on that K98 Talk. That would make me laugh. Welcome back to all our political geeks, freaks, and back alley sneaks. Everybody right now within the sound of my voice, you know exactly what to do. First thing, you tighten up your drink, you tighten up your snake, you tighten up whatever help makes you think. Then you get over to K98talk.org, get in that chat room, say hello to Stacey, join the smartest, latest, up all night, drinking as Ron put your pants on, Oy Vey Schmear, political radio audience in the business, JD and Stacey, baby, yo, radio after party.
Here we come, walk down the street.
Shmeek, what are you, stupid as a crowd out there?
Don't worry about it.
Hi. How are you?
Hi, I was wondering why the monkeys were playing.
Ha ha, we keep them on their toes, baby. Get them down. Tonight, Stacey and I are going to do it to the crowd. We're going to be talking with all the talk of third party, baby. JD and Stacey are here to tell you there is one. It's called the Libertarian Party.
Is it a natural home for disillusioned conservatives? Stacey and I break down platforms, planks, candidates, and much, much more. And of course, old listeners, new listeners, and everyone in between, we got nonsense in the world and so much more. Remember, guys, we're not just here Thursday nights live, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard, K98 Talk, doing some game on. We're live again Tuesday evenings, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard. Sunday mornings, I don't know how this broad talk me into it, but we do another live show at Game On, 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Only been 2 years.
Cure your mainstream media hangover. Friday, Hooples, get over it. We are your 5 p.m. drive time on that WNJC 1360 a.m. Serving that Philadelphia, Southern Jersey, Northern Delaware. Remember, get over to that Facebook. Find the JD and Stacey show page. You like it. You find 10 friends. You bring them over your house. What you do when you close them blinds, baby, that's all up to you and those 10 friends. But make sure before you do the weird stuff, you like the Facebook page. And after the show, Hooples, when you stick around for the boss, Jay Homestead, that Ricky Ticky Tavi Rick Robinson, taking you to the top of the 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Hour on that America Off the Rails. Then after that, kids, from midnight to the morning light, you get over to Spreaker.com. Hash Brown, JD and Stacey, JDANDSTACEY. Find out a catalog of everything we've been doing here with that Ricky Ticky Tavi Rick Robinson and that K98 Talk. Good evening, baby.
Good evening.
Hold on a second. I got to hit the little audio my bubble, the little radio, little man in the boat. Hold on a second. Okay, we are back. Good Thursday evening, baby. I think, you know, we've been having a conversation off the air about keeping everybody on their toes. You know what I'm saying? So I think we pop them in a little different tonight.
I guess so.
For those of you who are both new and old listeners of the show, we had the board did a little shuffle. The board is growing. So, look, all the news of the world. I want to tell everybody right now, if you tuned in for a little bit of you're in the wrong place. Put on CNN, okay? Nobody knows what's going on, all right? My theory? Oh, that didn't work. My theory. And you know who I think did it?
Oh, Durga.
And you know why I think they did it?
Virgin.
But other than that, nobody knows until we know what we don't know. Ain't that right, baby?
Yeah, is it going to be like that one that, what was it, the Malaysian airliner that we just still don't know?
You know, that story.
Didn't CNN, like, cover that for months?
Oh, my God. Don Lemon. Don't get me. Yeah. They had the big radio. I am trying so hard to put the filter on, being that we're up on NJC tomorrow. I'm just picturing Don Lemon just having his gaze. Oh, let me ask you about the. So, Bob, the plane has now been missing for 175 days. Hi, welcome back to CNN, your place for nothing. All right, Bob, so on day 176, after we've talked to every little Malaysian midget wearing a lei around their neck and whatever weird robe and kufi, and then every retired FBI agent who's trying to sell a book, after 176 days, you got Don Lemon and CNN still going over there. I wonder what the prevailing theory is. Let me tell you what the prevailing theory is, okay? It was God. It was Al-Qaeda. It was McDonnell Douglas with a failed gasket. Who the hell knows? Get over it.
There you go. And now they got a new one.
I'm sorry. Hold on a second. I got to give myself a little. They got a new what? New
plane? At least you know. A new plane that's disappeared.
After the insurance money, maybe they buy two planes.
Yeah, there you go.
Hold on a second. Our mixer is killing us tonight. Let me just reset this one more time. Because then you come through like sounding like some horror show, scary, creepy woman, lady man. We don't want to have that.
Well, yeah, we don't want my true self appearing on the radio. That would be horrible.
Oh, come on, baby. We love you. We love you, your true self. I'm trying to look up there. I got nothing.
I bring nothing to the table.
Okay.
There you go.
Tonight we're going to spend the hour. You know, there's been a lot of talk on the right-hand side. Basically, the Republican Party through this primary season has been completely fractured. And for those of you who look at it any differently, I respect your opinion. I just don't know how you can see it as such. The Republican Party has broken down into the Trump wing of the party and everybody else. And I think one of the things that have been frustrating to everybody who is the everybody else, or if you want to call it the Never Trump movement or however you want to look at it, is that...
Or the grudgingly Trump.
Right. You know, you have Bill Kristol, who I greatly respect, but from a tactical point of view, and I honestly think Bill Kristol pitching a third-party candidate goes back to what is wrong with the GOP that led us to where we are today. I really do. because he's selling a bill of goods. It really is a unicorn. I mean, would I like to see some white knight ride in from a third party that everybody on the right could coalesce around? Yes, I would. But if that candidate existed, the 60% of primary voters on the right who didn't vote for Donald Trump would have coalesced around that candidate. And it wasn't John Kerry. Oh, you know what? Let's give him a nod. It wasn't the mailman.
I'm going to miss him.
I'm not at all.
But you know.
But if for some reason we end up in Ohio, like, I don't know, near Cleveland, ugh.
Oh! Are you and I going to check out that
radio studio of the Lord?
No. We're not.
Well, you said, okay, terrific.
You said Cleveland. I was thinking 6 light bulbs, 500 watts. But if Ted Cruz was the write-in candidate, then the vote against Trump at the end of this primary cycle, you know, would have coalesced around him. And it really didn't. And I think that's why he got out of the race. So when you hear everybody saying, you know, we need a third party alternative, one of the things that gets glossed over, and some of this for good reason, is that, folks, there is a third party.
And there always has been a third party.
And there has been for decades, and they're on the ballot every 4 years when you go to vote in the presidential.
Not in all states a lot of times.
Correct. And that's the Libertarian Party. And the Libertarian Party is selecting its presidential nominee in Orlando this next coming weekend. And I don't think we could find a
better place. Only the Libertarians have their convention on a weekend. It's one of the reasons I like
it. Now, okay, for those of you who are new to the show, Stacey and I, we had theme songs for all the major presidential candidates. All right, baby? So we had Bernie Sanders, Uncle Speedo.
Boom, boom, boom.
We got Hillary Clinton. Kang.
La-di-da-di, we like...
No, why do I keep hitting that?
Oh, my God, that's so not Hillary Clinton.
No, here she is. She's, I told you, the board shift. And then we have one. Trumpkins, your time to shine. Hand off Schmeckle, Trumpkins, here on radio. Hand off Schmeckle, here on radio. We have one for little
it's
Donnie.
It's Daddy.
You're so vain.
You're fired. Now, for those of you who've been scared off by the Libertarian Party because, you know, everybody's crazy over there. Well, we'll get into that a little bit. But this is not yo daddy's Libertarian Party. Austin Peterson is one of the three main candidates who's going to be that's running for the nomination, has one of the best quotes. Stacey and I love this quote. And Austin Peterson, one of the candidates for president on the Libertarian side, says he dreams of a world in which, quote, gay married couples can defend their marijuana fields with fully automatic machine guns. So, ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, JD and Stacey are premiering for you tonight our new official Libertarian Party presidential race theme song.
Three simple words. I am gay. Three simple words. I am gay.
Oh, I love that. I think that's going to live for a while. Now, Stacey and I both
now,
have...
Because...
Let me just finish, and I'm going to toss it over to you. Stacey and I both have very libertarian leanings, but I actually wanted to throw it over to her because, you know, before she became politically active and on the right side of the aisle, she really did come from the Libertarian Party. And why don't you give everybody in the audience, baby, 18 to 80, blind, crippled, and crazy, a little prim and a primer of what it means to be a libertarian, what's the basic philosophy, and coming into this weekend's convention, you know, what are some of their larger planks that people may be concerned about?
Well, I think it's actually been kind of interesting to watch, but, you know, some of their primary philosophy is individual liberty. That if I'm not hurting you or preventing you from making a living or somehow adversely affecting you personally, you really shouldn't be telling me what to do. And, you know, I think that idea is something that most conservatives would say they agree with wholeheartedly, but when you get down into the positions on various planks of the party, conservatives, whoa, wait a minute. You know, from the time I was about 19, I identified as a libertarian. Didn't really start supporting GOP candidates wholeheartedly until about...
Wait. If you identified as a libertarian...
2004, 2000.
If you identified as a libertarian, did that mean that you used to have to use the libertarian bathroom?
Okay, terrific. Oh,
okay, terrific. Yeah. Those were always co-ed.
Ooh.
Oh.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
That's okay. You know, I identified as a libertarian from the time I could vote. I think I drove my parents nutty because they just didn't get it. And I love them both to death. But really moved towards the conservative side of the house.
Nothing works here.
He said you drove him nutty.
No, I'm just saying it. Yeah. Came over to the conservative side of the house basically in 2000 because I lived in Illinois and I knew what Barack Obama was. Had to beat him and that didn't work out so well. So, you know, became a conservative activist. And I will say that my perspective, and I've kind of articulated this in a couple different places over time, has changed on certain things. You know, the libertarian platform in total has become somewhat utopian to me. In a perfect world, yeah, a lot of that stuff works.
What party platform and plank, as stated at the convention, isn't? Like what party's platform and plank, as stated at the convention, is not some kind of unicorn thought factory?
Well, I mean, it might be somewhat visionary, but what I'm talking about is... open borders. Okay, open borders don't work with our entitlement state. So until you can fix our entitlement system where run over the border, we're going to give you $6,000 a month, free health care, your kids are going to get educated, we're going to teach them English because we're saps like that. Until you can fix those things that you're not creating incentives for people to cross the border, you can't even think about changing our immigration system.
And basically,
that's like step 20, not step one.
And basically, you know, to Stacey's point, the Libertarian Party basically is a broad mix of constitutionalists, your occasional anarchist, you know, and people who really are interested in individual liberty and freedom. Yeah, but that's a pretty broad statement there, Jenny and Stacey. I know, Bob, and we're going to get to a little more specifics. It's one of the reasons that their convention coming up in Orlando this weekend is going to be so hotly watched, because you now, for the first time, you know, third parties in this country, and a lot of it has to do with money and funding, and I also have my own personal theory about people getting into a voting booth and actually feeling like they have to tactically instead of principally cast their vote. You know, because I hear people that want to do this Ted Cruz writing campaign. I do not want to dissuade anybody from voting their heart and their principles, but I think that a lot of people dismiss, you know, some third-party candidates in cycles when they may have something to offer just because they go, oh, well, that's going to be a wasted vote. Well, if you and everybody who thought that way didn't say, well, let me take a vote and put the jersey on for the team, you may see more of that. And to that point, you see more and more people that are self-identifying as non-party specific and as independents. And to that point, Gary Johnson, who's the former governor of New Mexico, was the Libertarian Party's candidate in 2012. He was the first Libertarian Party candidate to garner over 1 million votes, and he got just about 1% of the overall general electorate vote. The record is in the Libertarian Party is like 1.06 from back in the day. But one of the reasons that you're going to be scrutinizing it so much is because, to Stacey's point, everybody has fresh eyes on something. And, you know, nobody's made the move fully over yet because there are certain things. To Stacey's point, I have a problem with some of their national security positions. I have a problem in a lot of ways with their open border provisions. But that brings me to Austin Peterson and two of the other candidates who are running. Austin Peterson intrigued me because not that pro-life. I'm libertarian enough that, to me, the pro-life issue, because even if Roe v. Wade went away tomorrow, it's going to be remanded back to the states, and nothing's going to change where I live here. And, you know, so from that point of view, I'm libertarian enough on the pro-life issue that, to me, it's really a personal issue. It's not something I vote on. But when I heard that Austin Peterson was a pro-life libertarian candidate, I said,
For the first time, it turned my eyes and I said, you know something, maybe the planks in that platform are malleable because even a third party needs to broaden its tent in order to be competitive. And you have all these conservatives out there. So the Libertarian candidate is certain to advocate several welcome policies that neither major party nominee is going to touch with the 10-foot pole. And fiscal conservatives who are anxious about the debt, they're going to be happy to hear that all three leading Libertarian contenders, former New Mexico Republican Governor Gary Johnson, again, who was the 2012 nominee, antivirus software designer John McAfee, who Stacey and I are really not going to touch and consider viable, which in the second segment you'll find out why, and 35-year-old Libertarian media entrepreneur, Austin
That's not P- the only reason we're not going to touch him.
First there was...
Oops! Giggity, 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 let's have sex!
And then there
I think
was,
I almost needed a bell there.
Then,
never mind.
Then there was... And then you have Austin Peterson, who is the third of them. So now you actually have some appeal within the Libertarian Party to the left as well. Progressives who are all down with Bernie's,
anybody who wants to come smoke pot with Uncle Speedo, come smoke weed with me, and we can run around in the woods and go, boom, boom, boom.
You know, they are also pretty much for legalization and have opposition to a lot of drug prohibition as well, as
and a lot of it has to do with the criminal justice implications and the costs.
Exactly, and as well as some interventionism. So again, this is a topic that we're going to take two full spots on right now. When we come back on the other side, we're going to go into the three candidates real quick. We're going to tell you why McAfee. We're going to tell you why McAfee very soon, baby, may not to be. We'll talk about marijuana fields and machine guns, automatic weapons, some serious stuff, how fascism can creep into all this, and whether or not we got conservatives ready to make a move over to that Libertarian Party. Party, baby. But before we do that, JD and Stacey, game on, part of that Conservative Commandos Radio Network on that K98 Talk. That show getting so big, baby, even Diamond Dave got to take us to break. We're coming right back.
One break coming up.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it. There to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
If you like your health care plan, you'll be able to keep your health care plan.
This is the most transparent administration in history. Not even a smidgen of corruption.
Fact is, we had four dead Americans. What difference at this point does it make?
If you've got a business, you didn't build that.
The feeling most people get when they hear a Barack Obama speech, I felt this thrill going up my leg. I don't have that too often.
Steady.
It's time to hear the truth about America's biggest challenges. Ricky Robinson, host of America Off the Rails, will tackle the important issues facing America today as he tries to keep America from coming off the track. Get ready to hear the truth every Monday through Friday starting at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 Central, here on K98Talk.com and the Spark Radio Network.
Are you conservative in a world of liberal?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you're not alone. Hey, I'm Daniel Stafford, host of the Stafford Voice, and I'd like to invite you to tune in each Monday, 10 p.m. Eastern, where I'll break down the events of the week, and together we'll learn about how they affect you. So, sit back and get ready for the good, the bad, and the ugly of talk radio right here on K98 Talk.
From the Vikings of Norway to my home down south to Washington, D.C., I've been around. I've seen it all, and I've come out on top. You better beware, for all you know, the bell tolls for you. Enter the bell tower or watch your step. 8 p.m. Thursdays, K98 Talk.
Welcome back, truckers, suckers, and bad. JD and Stacey, part of that Conservative Commandos radio network here on Game On, K98 Talk. Everybody, you know what to do. You get over to K98Talk.org right now, get in that chat room, say hello to Stacey. You go, Ron, pants on, oy vey schmear. Join the conversation. Remember, guys, we're live again every Tuesday night as well, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time here on K98 Talk. Sunday morning, this crazy woman talked me into it. We do a show live at 11 in the morning. We do that Game On. We carry your mainstream media hangover Friday. That's tomorrow for those of you that went to public school. We're the drive time leading to that Yahoo Sports on that WNWNWNJC 1360 AM, covering that Philadelphia, Southern Jersey, Northern Delaware. Get over to the Facebook page, JD and Stacey. Like it, get 10 friends, do weird things with them, but make sure they like it too. Remember that after the show, guys. Stick around for the boss, that Ricky Tiki Tavi Rick Robinson, that Jay Holmes there going to the top of the 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Hour on that America Off the Rails. Then after that, Hooples, you get over to Spreaker.com, hashtag JD and Stacey, JDANDSTACEY. Find a catalog of everything we've been doing here from midnight to the morning light. Welcome back, baby.
Thank you very much.
I'm so excited. We have the new theme song for the Libertarian Party to make sure we keep true to who we are as a show.
There you go.
And
well, I think If you look at the folks that talk to me on social media, I was for Rand Paul and now I'm for Donald Trump. All I do, you were in it for the pot, weren't you? I mean, that was the only part of the platform attention to. There is not a libertarian bone in Donald Trump's body.
Why do you think the Libertarian Party theme song has a Peter Tosh inspiration?
I knew why it had a Peter Tosh inspiration. I'm not silly.
Hey, man. You are really, really ruining my butt.
I'm
listening to me. I'm listening
the
to
whole,
people.
The whole drug legalization thing is a minute part of their platform. I was always a lot more interested in their economic platform, their taxation platform, their limited government platform. Those are the places that I think conservatives have a ton of overlap with libertarians.
Yeah, hey, man, is the smart lady done talking? I want to get back to the libertarians, man.
Okay, terrific.
I wanted to circle back to and one of the reasons we're going to drop McAfee after this is there really are only two main candidates coming into the convention this weekend, and that is the former governor of New Mexico, Gary Johnson, as well as Austin Peterson. And the third one is, yes, when you hear McAfee,
is that the McAfee that invented the antivirus stuff there, Jenny and Stacey? It blocks all my porn.
Yes, Bob, the stuff that blocks all your porn. Well, anyway.
He doesn't use it on his own computer.
No, but he is one of the libertarian American dream cats, right? So this whacked out guy McAfee invents McAfee virus and does what the rest of us would do. He bought an island, down wherever. So now, this is from an article on libertarians in the LA Times this past week. McAfee, who seems to have taken the Dos Equis Most Interesting Man in the World ad campaign as a personal dare, I thought that was Pete Johnson, is an international fugitive wanted for questioning in Belize in connection with the alleged murder of his neighbor. He is. Now, listen, for those of you who think it's bad if Lil Donnie gets elected and Mrs. Borat becomes first lady, Jewish reporter, very nice. Yes, okay, Mrs. Borat, great. No. On top of him being an international fugitive who's wanted in the questioning for murder, McAfee is married to a former sex slave that he rescued, according to his account. Anyway.
Okay, terrific.
But we don't know how they met.
What were you on
the word eccentric applied to McAfee is is kind.
I mean,
he would not garner any bit of a conservative vote. I don't consider him a viable candidate. I would rather focus on Johnson and Peterson.
We will, but was married to a former sex slave that he, according to his account, quote unquote, rescued. From where? Was he on the sex plantation? I mean, I don't understand. Were there like sex slaves out in the field?
Hey, where are the white women at?
I don't know, JD.
Well, did they go on the Sex Underground Railroad? I mean, this is just...
I don't want to talk about this anymore.
Just the bizarre... So let's get back to most people know Johnson being that he was their last nominee. A lot of people don't know Austin Peterson. Austin Peterson, broken down at a glance, is a constitutional, this is according to his own bio, is a constitutional libertarian who believes in economic freedom and personal liberty. Peterson's passion for limited government led him to a job at the Libertarian National Committee in 2008. Eventually, he went on to the Atlas Economic Research Center. He was an associate producer for Judge Andrew Napolitano's show Freedom Watch on the Fox Business Network.
One of my favorites.
After the show's cancellation, Austin returned to D.C. to work for the Tea Party Institution Freedom Works and subsequently started his own business venture called Stonegate GAIT LLC. You need to listen to the description of it, because if you want to understand true libertarianism, the first thing it says is Stonegate LLC is a for-profit business. It's the first thing that you see, and I'm like,
all right. As all businesses should be.
But one of the things that intrigues me about Peterson is that he and Johnson is the Andrew Breitbart nominee. And the reason that I say that is, you know, Andrew's whole thing was that politics is downstream of culture. And he very much felt that we on the right had ceded the culture war to the left and took ourselves out of pop culture, which is a really good vehicle to drive your message. The left does it all the time, whether it's in movies, magazines, what have you. This guy is a guy who is a producer, and not just on the television side. He's done some entertainment things as well. And before,
he was an underwear model, wasn't he?
You want to know what? I thankfully missed that in the bio. But
yeah,
he's a little hottie. One of the things that you guys are going to see as a running theme when you look into the Libertarian candidates is that you're going to see constant speaking about a repeal of the 17th Amendment.
Now, what's the 17th Amendment, Jenny and Stacey? There's so many of them, I can't remember.
I'm glad you asked, Bob. The 17th basically establishes the popular election of U.S. senators by the people of the states. It superseded Article 1, Clauses 1 and 2, which senators were elected by the state legislatures. It was ratified in 1913. The Libertarian Party, one of their main planks, is making sure they strip that out. Now, Stacey, how much do you think there's synergy between not lost, but conservatives right now who are looking for a home and for people inside the true Libertarian Party, at least as it's constructed in 2016?
Well, I think Austin Peterson's actually disrupting it a little bit. You take a look at, you know, Gary Johnson's answer on, for example, religious freedom restoration acts, his position is actually blatantly non-libertarian and kind of progressive. Austin Peterson has the right answer, you know, and everybody has always made the mistake that libertarians support abortion. No, libertarians take the view that JD expressed earlier, that abortion is a personal decision. And that really there are market reasons to do a lot of things. So if you can appropriately market your ideals, such as traditional marriage, two-parent families, et cetera, and there's data that supports all of those things are better for children, da-da-da-da-da, you can actually make a dent in the culture. And we've made that dent with the pro-life movement without ever making it illegal. I think Charles C.W. Cook outlined that beautifully in the Conservatarian Manifesto. Being pro-life doesn't mean we want a constitutional amendment ending abortion. Right. It means we want people to understand and respect the value of life. And that we have to maybe as a society come to grips with beyond a certain point, it's a little barbaric. But I mean, when you take a look at where I think everybody comes together really well. I mentioned it before. Economic policy, federal regulation, federal agencies that have no constitutional basis, taxation, right? So when you take a look at a lot of the domestic policies that are really squeezing and kind of stepping on the necks of people in the country, libertarians and conservatives agree. Where they fall apart are largely on issues of foreign policy and social policy. And my personal perspective is simply this. 60% of Americans aren't happy with either party. Approximately 60% of Americans for years have said they are fiscally conservative and somewhat socially liberal. If those statistics are true, and there could be some negotiation between the conservative base and the libertarian base, and everybody's going to have to give up something to come up with a platform that works, could put a coalition together that could be amazing.
That's why I couch the question in the context of as you see it structured in 2016, because I think that, you know, pieces are going to have to be picked up somewhere. You know, the conservative right is going to have to decide whether it is worth fighting inside the Republican Party to take it back. I personally, at this moment in time,
I don't think so.
I am outside of that. And I think that for us, it's either that through the next few election cycles, we find parties or candidates through which we can vote our principles and our beliefs, or if you're looking for something that's viable, to Stacey's point, there has to be give and take, and there hasn't had to be a lot of give and take for the paleo libertarians, you know, the ones that are complete doctrinaire libertarians. But if you look at this new Libertarian Party, and if you look at a party that may have the ability to compete, because again, back in the beginning, there are Bernie Sanders supporters it's going to peel off on its left flanks, and there are very conservative supporters it's going to peel off on its right flanks. What I see is whether it's Austin Peterson with his pro-life position, or whether it was what was the plank that you said that was really progressive for Johnson?
Religious Freedom Restoration Act. His answer was just wrong.
I understand that, but you start to see that there may be room for a true party to grow instead of just somebody saying, hey, man, I was libertarian before it was cool, and now that all you people showed up and know about it, I'm going to find something else to do. There's always going to be people like that inside of any structure. But before we end up tying up the segment, Stacey had actually brought to my attention a Brookings Institute piece by Robert Kagan.
Is that the Robert Kagan I'm thinking about, Teddy and Stacey?
Yes, it is, but he's an academic, so like any egghead, you know, sometimes he gets it right, sometimes he gets it wrong. I'm not going to come down on either side of the article writ large, but there's a piece of it right here, Stacey, and I think that 2016 in this election cycle really could be a moment in time to tell whether or not enough conservatives can find themselves comfortably at home within the Libertarian Party. And this is from Kagan's piece, and this was from the Brookings Institute as published in the Washington Post. He speaks of a creeping fascism through the nationalism of the way that the Trump campaign is being run, and he refers to it as a mobocracy. Now, this is the piece right here, Stacey, where I wonder if the way that he posits it's here, if you agree with it and it bears out to be true, if this doesn't really what aligns the synergy of those conservatives looking for a home. Kagan goes on, conservatives have been warning for decades about government suffocating liberty. This is where he's referring to mobocracy. But here is the other threat to liberty that Alexis de Tocqueville and the ancient philosophers warned about, that the people in democracy, excited, angry, and unconstrained, might run roughshod roughshod over even the institutions created to preserve their freedoms. That's where I think the Libertarian Party comes in. As Alexander Hamilton watched the French Revolution unfold, he feared in America what he saw play out in France, that the unleashing of a popular passions would lead not to greater democracy, but to the arrival of a tyrant riding to power on the shoulders of the people.
Well, and I think, yeah, the conservatives have been warning about liberty's erosion, and I think a lot of the frustration you're seeing in the electorate is just that. Congress is at a deadlock. We have crony capitalism. You know, my children, have never experienced free market capitalism like we did growing up. I mean, it's always been very managed by the government. Government creates winners and losers on a regular basis. And libertarians are against corporate welfare. I'm against corporate welfare. I think most conservatives are against corporate welfare. I think if we could develop a coalition that could agree to focus on the institutional priorities first, rolling back executive power, making Congress function the way that it was meant to function, having a representative of the people and a representative of the states, turning some of those tax dollars back to states and local communities to run education, to run local programs, and do the things that are done much better when they're closer to home and much more efficiently. If you could build a coalition that was willing to agree to do those things first before you start talking about broader changes to foreign policy or social policy, I think you might have something that could work.
And this is going to be a broader primer as we go forward of Stacey and I just opening up and presenting options, opportunities, and giving you some education and context to some things you may have been thinking about but may not fully have had the time to go into yourself. But the one thing you ain't going to find here, baby. You want to know why? Go to CNN for Don Lemon and that. I told you exactly what happened. Everybody got on the plane, right? So everybody got on the plane. And then all of a sudden...
Oh, durka, durka, durka.
For the
Virgin.
Thanks, Scott. So JD and Stacey coming into the top of the 10 o'clock hour. We got one more segment left. Of course, kids, we got to bring you nonsense of the world. Something about a woman taking a ball bat to some guy's car. He was at the gas pump. I don't know if I'm ever taking the kids to Disneyland again. But we'll discuss like Linda Richmond. All right, when we come back, JD and Stacey, fastest hour on conservative radio, getting set to wrap up here. We're going to pay a couple of bills. Coming right back on that K98 Talk, part of that Conservative Commandos Radio Network.
Hey everybody, this is Jason, host of According to Me. I'd like to invite you to check out my show. It's a two-hour show that lasts 60 minutes in...
Listen, I hate to interrupt, but one thing I can do is read off a script. Just say, let me be clear a lot. It works.
President Obama, I can handle this. It's a radio promo. I'm not green. I've done this before.
Did someone say green?
Now, Al Gore is here. Listen, I'm just trying to record a radio promo. Do you mind?
Now, do you say good things about me on the show?
No, not at all. But if it makes you feel any better, I rip on Republicans just as much.
The AM radio frequencies give off very high levels of radiation.
Look, my show is on the internet, which you invented. I mean, can I just do my promo?
I got a pen. I can veto that, you know.
I know you got a pen. It's not a law. It's a radio promo. Listen, just listen to my show. Barack Obama and Al Gore hate it, so you're going
to
love it.
Here's an executive order. Don't listen to a show. He doesn't like me. He's racist. And he doesn't recycle either.
That's it. I'm done. It's According to Me, Wednesdays, 10 p.m. Eastern, right here on K98 Talk.
Wondering why you're up early with us on a Sunday morning making a cocktail? News lately got you drinking? Hungover from the mainstream media by Sunday? We are, and we got you covered.
We sure do. We got your hangover cure for those weekly news blues. So sit back, top off your mimosa, and add some Baileys to that coffee.
Take a match to your copy of the New York Times. Light, funny, and oh yeah, news with booze.
And a lot of laughter.
Welcome to Bloody Marys and Broadsheets. If it's Sunday, it's Bloody Marys and Broadsheets.
We're your cure from your weekly news hangover.
We will never fully understand what we've asked of our military service members or their families, asking them to put themselves in harm's way, to endure it all. But we do understand that it's our turn, our duty, to keep them secure for the rest of their lives. Wounded Warrior Project long-term support programs help our most severely ill or injured veterans live independently, at no cost, for life, so that they might stand at ease. Join us at findwwp.org.
K98 Talk is expanding its lineup for 2015. This means we are expanding our advertising base. Whether you're a startup trying to push through to the next level, or an established business trying to supplement your advertising budget, web-based advertising is a solid investment. Thanks to Talk's newest partnership with TuneIn Radio and instant access to our sister station, K98 FM, we give you worldwide access at a reasonable cost. Interested parties should email us at sales@k98fm.com.
Well, Welcome back, suckers, truckers, and bear. JD and Stacey here, back game on that K98 Talk. Everybody, you know what to do. Oy vey shmir, K98Talk.org. Get in the chat room. Say hello to Stacey. Join the conversation. Remember, guys, live here on K98, Tuesday, Thursday, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. 11 a.m., we cure your mainstream media hangover. Friday with a 5 p.m. drive time leading to that Yahoo Sports. On a WNWNWN, JC 1360 AM, 7 at Philadelphia, Southern Jersey, Northern Delaware, baby. Get over to Spreaker.com after you watch the watch. So after you listen to The Boss and Jay Homestead tonight, going into the 11 o'clock hour in America Off the Rails, get over to Spreaker.com, hashtag JD and Stacey, find out a catalog of everything we've been doing here and the places we didn't do it. And then there was a guy we worked for, and now he does, he preaches in a church and he broadcasts on walkie-talkies and...
Oh, dear Lord.
Oh, my God. Can we...
Okay, terrific.
I think it's going to be... Oh. We have absolutely no more news about... Deflin! It's missing. You know what? This is such a statement on the human condition. So, last night in the middle of the night, because JD doesn't sleep, I see the news breaking that there's a plane missing, right? And then, for the last almost 24 hours, you have every news station and news organization and website breathlessly going, what happened? What happened to the plane? What happened to the plane? Okay. As soon as the plane disappeared, they put a red dot on the screen about where the plane disappeared. The plane disappeared south of Turkey, north of Egypt, west of Syria, and east of northern Africa. So,
good luck with all
okay,
that.
Okay, terrific.
Oh, my God. Could you imagine if that plane crashed and you end up in one of those Durka Durka mud hut tribes? And you're like, oh, my God, I survived an A320 crash. Wow, this looks like the desert. Oh, are you the chief?
Who is your daddy and what does he do?
I don't know, Edith. I don't know if we're going to have a good time here on this island. I also think it's going to be interesting if this is the moment in time for the libertarians and the conservatives to unite and try and use their powers for good instead of evil.
Well, I think, as I said, there's just going to have to be some recognition on the side of social conservatives that, you know what? If you're not gay, nobody's going to make you marry somebody of the same sex. If somebody else wants to, just whatever. You don't have to socialize. You still have the freedom of association, et cetera. And if you can get down to those tenets of individual liberty and the First Amendment in terms of how we interact as in a society, I think everybody can just calm down.
And before we get on to the nonsense of the world, to wrap up that segment, the Republican Party and the conservatives right now be like, oh.
Everybody was kung fu fighting.
You just had to say that because you have to play that song every show now.
I do, but now we can go from that to...
Legalize.
Three simple words. I am gay. Gay weddings, gigantic joints, and machine guns. I mean, basically sounds like some of the people I know in New York.
Okay, terrific.
All right, you want to get the angry lady from Los Angeles out of the way first?
Sure. Let's talk about the angry lady from Los Angeles.
Woman accused, this is from CBS in Los Angeles, out of Lancaster, LA. A woman accused of taking bat to man's car for staying in front of gas pump for too long. If you don't think the people in this country are about to pop, a violent confrontation was caught on camera at a gas station in the high desert. Cell phone video of the incident from the Valero gas station in Lancaster showed a woman who's accused of repeatedly hitting a man's truck with a bat. The woman apparently is an employee at the station. The owner of the vandalized truck, identified only as Ray, Jesus, said he was shocked and feared for his own safety. In the clip, the woman is seen standing in front of the truck and counting before taking the bat to the truck's back taillight. She's heard telling him, quote, I told you to move. Now, as you go to the end of the article, Ray said he suspects the incident unfolded because he was sitting in his truck making calls after he filled his tank. Then they bury the lead by saying Ray then admits he lost track of time, possibly sitting in his truck at the pump for an hour on the phone. Ray is lucky that I wasn't the one with a baseball bat behind his stupid ass sitting at the gate.
Hi, Bob. But hold on, Bob. Let me call you back. I got another call. Oh, hi. Is this Joe? Yeah, Joe. Me? No, I just filled up the tank. What am I doing? I'm sitting in front of it on the phone. Hold on, Joe. There's a crazy woman with a baseball bat coming to tune up my truck. Ugh.
Do you have anything to say on this?
I don't. That just takes road rage to a whole new level. But I also think there should be certain rules that people just abide by. I don't bring 50 items into the 10-item express, and don't sit in front of the gas pump when you're done pumping gas, period.
And if you do, and Stacey pulls up, you're going to be
everybody
like,
was kung fu fighting.
I'm
okay,
mean.
Terrific.
I'm terrifying. Even Slick is scared of me. I think
all
that's
right.
Awesome.
Black Lives Matter has completely ruined the world. Has completely. This is as bad as when MTV stopped playing videos. I now live in a world, according to CBS in Detroit, can white kids grow up to be black? Some preschoolers think so. We're not talking about back in the day when all the suburban white kids wanted to be Eminem and all the guys from Compton, and they were wearing their pants around their ankles with their drawers hanging out with their hats sideways, and they were driving around in Rolls Royces just like the rappers, except that they were their parents. No, we're talking about officially jump the shark, same kind of nonsense.
Hey, where are the white women at?
With this Bantam stuff. This is out of Ann Arbor. Can a person's race change over time? No, but preschoolers seem to think so. Can somebody tell
but
me?
But preschoolers don't have those constructs. They can't believe this story was even published.
I know preschoolers that think they can be a fire truck. According to a University of Michigan study, white preschool. All right, so all the white people out there, you're screwed, all right? Make sure the kids don't go to school because now they're asking them asinine questions about, you want to be black? Yeah, hey, you want to be a fire truck? Oh, yeah, sure. No, but preschoolers seem to think so. According to a University of Michigan study, white preschoolers often believe a person's race can change over time. The youngsters even think, well, Michael Jackson's did, and the youngsters even think they can grow up to become black adults. Stephen Roberts, a University of Michigan doctoral student and the study's lead author, said that although children may be aware of races other than their own, they don't have a strong understanding of what race is. That. Will you save me from myself in this article, please?
Yeah, I mean, to me, this is like, gee, wow, preschoolers are still developing their social constructs and figuring out how the world works. No kidding. This is not even earth-shattering news, but they're making such a big deal out of it.
Oh, hey, little Johnny, what did you learn in school today? Oh, I learned the ABCs, the 1, 2, 3s, and...
Hey, where are the white women at?
Oh, fantastic. I'm so proud of my country.
I mean, kids are, like, struggling to understand the world around them, and the world around them is a heck of a lot more complex today than it was when we were kids.
You want to do Disney evidently breeding serial killers as some of their workers?
Oh, my God. These people, whiny little millennials, okay? I'm sorry. Disney World is an experience. If you've ever been there, it's hell
it's
for adults, but
world.
Children love it. Huh?
It's a small world after all.
Oh, my God. But anyway, the whole idea is when you see a Disney princess, it is that Disney princess. When you see Pooh Bear, he acts like Pooh Bear. No. Disney princesses are not 6'1" and do not weigh 280 pounds. I'm sorry.
That's not how any of this works.
All right?
Please go
and
on to
nobody,
some of the revelations.
Nobody in fairy tales has pink hair and nose rings.
Oh, in mine they do. In mine they do.
That's because you don't want to go to Disney World in Florida. You want to go to Sausage Castle.
I want to buy Sausage Castle. So why don't you go through some of the list of horribles of these staff members where everybody
thinks
it's the happiest
place in the world.
Oh,
my God. They can't have the job they want because their noses are pierced. People are mean to them, and they cry when they have to be the princess. They have to be the princess the whole time they're in the costume so as not to ruin the illusion. Disney World is supposed to be like the embodiment of the magical world of Disney. You're not supposed to ruin the illusion. That's what people are paying for.
Disneyland mixed with some sugar is the closest you can get to giving kids mescaline. All right, 36 hours a day. We got less than a minute. What is this nonsense?
Nobody. No, this is 36 minutes a day. People only relax for 36 minutes a day. And most people in the UK, and let me tell you, they work a lot less than we do in the US. I'm just saying. Feel like they don't get enough rest. They don't get an adequate break from work. And when they are on a break from work, they're actually doing personal things like shopping, running errands, or doing bills. So they're tired all the time. But now there's some thing where if the Brits drink a cup of tea and switch from regular Earl Grey to green tea, they feel better. And if they incorporate other green foods, it lifts their mood. So you can combat tiredness by adding a lot of green liquids and leafy vegetables and types of food.
JD's advice, you want to add something green to your diet that'll let you relax more than 36 minutes a day? Just... Hi, and that's the best way to listen to, but unfortunately wrapping up the fastest hour in conservative radio. We want to thank everybody for joining Stacey and I tonight on Game On, part of that Conservative Commandos radio network on that K98 Talk. We love all our listeners, 18 to 80, blind, crippled, and crazy, baby. To all our old listeners, new listeners, and everybody in between, this is the time in the program where I turn to my beautiful and brilliant co-host and I go, baby girl, baby girl, baby girl, you got those keys?
Oh, I got those keys.
Let's get out of here.
Okie dokie.
Tell the nice people where they can. Tell them!
You can always find me on Twitter at @ScottsFire, @ScottsFire, and on Facebook at Stacey Lennox.
You're never going to find me in a radio studio in some slept-up church in Cleveland, but you can find me on Game On JD, on the Twitters, bar stools, alleyways, TV situations. Bulletproof vest is back on. Somebody's going to take a shot at me. If I live through it, I'll see you guys Sunday morning.
I'm looking for you, you Occupy freaks, with your glitter bombs. Bring it on! Bring on the glitter. Everything has changed. Everything has changed in the last few years. Conservatives used to take it, and we're not taking it anymore.
If you want to work until you keel over, have less of everything in retirement, or give back more of your hard-earned money to the stock market again, then just ignore me. But if you'd like to protect the money you save, receive a steady, predictable retirement income, and enjoy financial security for as long as you live, then listen to this. You can download a free report that reveals the wealth-building secrets Wall Street and the banks don't want you to know. You'll learn how you can get guaranteed growth, safety, and real prosperity without risking your money in the Wall Street casino, and how to get the money you need when you need it, simply by asking for it. This is the best way to have a 100% secure retirement and know your money will last as long as you do. To learn more about this method and to get your free report, go to 29security.com. That's the number 29security.com. 29security.com. Go to 29security.com. If you want to work until you keel over, have less of everything in retirement, or give back more of your hard-earned money to the stock market again, then just ignore me. But if you'd like to protect the money you save, receive a steady, predictable retirement income, and enjoy financial security for as long as you live, then listen to this. You can download a free report that reveals the wealth-building secrets Wall Street and the banks don't want you to know. You'll learn how you can get guaranteed growth, safety, and real prosperity without risking your money in the Wall Street casino, and how to get the money you need when you need it, simply by asking for it. This is the best way to have a 100% secure retirement and know your money will last as long as you do. To learn more about this method and to get your free report, go to 29security.com. That's the number 29security.com. 29security.com. Go to 29security.com.
That's not how it works. That's not how any of this works.